Hi, this is Mark Brown with Game Maker's Toolkit, a series on video game design. If you're directing a movie or a TV show, you've got lots of tools at your disposal that you can use to reinforce the theme or the tone or the genre of your story. By tweaking elements like the score, the editing, the camera angles, and the lighting, you can make a scene feel suspenseful or lonely or surprising or whatever. But what fascinates me about video games is that you have this entire extra variable you can tweak to completely change the way the player feels, and that's the game design itself. The way you employ different mechanics and systems can dramatically alter the player's emotional response to the game. A good example of this is Far Cry 2 versus Far Cry 3 and 4, though I'll stick to Far Cry 4 for this video because it looks better. Far Cry 2 and 4 are both games about entering a dangerous country and being tasked with assassinating some big bad dude, either the Jackal in Far Cry 2 or Pagan Min in Far Cry 4. You'll wander about taking missions, using cars and boats, and using lots of guns to shoot lots of bad dudes. So, from the outside, they're perhaps not too different, but ask anyone who's actually played both games, and they'll tell you that these are actually polar opposite experiences. Far Cry 4 comes off feeling like a playground, built for your amusement and eager to make you have fun, whereas Far Cry 2 feels like this harrowing journey into a hostile landscape where you feel alone, desperate, and outgunned. If Far Cry 2 is Apocalypse Now, then Far Cry 4 is Tropic Thunder or something. You know, you start to wonder how these games can be in the same series at all. So why do these games feel so different if they're largely about the same thing? Well, there's a laundry list of mechanical differences between the two games that change the way you feel as a player. For starters, in Far Cry 2, weapons are rusty and they get jammed at the worst possible time, and vehicles are much more prone to getting damaged, so you'll spend more time repairing them. Both feel hostile to the player and they leave you exposed. Far Cry 4 has fast travel, where you can immediately jump around the map and magically teleport to a place that has health and ammo. In Far Cry 2, you have to catch the bus and can only fast travel from and to a handful of locations. Far Cry 2 also has guard checkpoints at every turn. You have to physically get out a map to know where you're going. It's actually quite scary at nighttime, and you definitely can't tag enemies and then track them through the walls. Oh, and you have malaria. Yeah, that's right, you are constantly at risk of coming down with a fever midway through a mission, and if you don't keep stocked up on pills, you can die. A big difference between the two games is the way saving is handled. Far Cry 4 gives you checkpoints at every turn, and you won't lose much progress if you kick the bucket. In Far Cry 2, and this is on consoles, there are no checkpoints and no quick saves. You can only save at a few locations, and if you die in the field, you can lose like half an hour of play. That sounds annoying, I agree, but it makes your mortality loom over your head and it changes the way you interact with the game. Because when one wrong move could wipe tons of progress, you'll move slowly and deliberately, and each enemy encounter feels impossibly tense. Compare that to Far Cry 4, where it doesn't really matter if you die, so I guess you can just jump off a building and stab a guy in the head and whatever. There is a buddy system in Far Cry 2 where you can be revived by a mercenary pal, but then that dude can die trying to save you, which just adds emotional trauma to the long list of things that suck about existing in the world of Far Cry 2. There's loads more, including the more unpredictable and deadly fire propagation system in Far Cry 2, and Far Cry 4's cramped map where it seems like you're never 20 centimeters away from a safe area, but I want to finish by talking about the guns. Far Cry 4 has a ridiculous arsenal of overpowered guns, including several silent sniper rifles that let you wipe out entire armies just by sitting in a bush taking headshots. The closest you get to a silent sniper rifle in Far Cry 2 is the dart gun, but it's hard to get, it degrades really quickly, and you can only carry a few bullets at a time. You can't rely on it, and you have to use other tactics to get through the game. It's a good example of how Far Cry 4 gives you all the tools and elephants you could need to have a good time, while Far Cry 2 kicks you in the teeth and pushes you into a muddy puddle. And that's amazing, because this isn't about which game is better, though I think the answer is Far Cry 2, but how Ubisoft managed to make two completely different games, largely by changing the mechanics of how the games play. By pushing back against the player and being abrasive, Far Cry 2 is an intense and slightly traumatic adventure. But by embracing the player and opening up its toy box, Far Cry 4 is a goofy action movie about getting high and blowing stuff up. The only thing you need to worry about is the wildlife. So if you're making a game, remember that telling a story doesn't stop at the plot, dialogue and cutscenes, the mechanics and systems that you choose also elicit emotions and contribute to the tone of the piece, and they should hopefully work in harmony with your plot. I want to talk more about games that do a good and a bad job at this in future episodes, but for now, go play some Far Cry 2. It's pretty good.